Emotional Intelligence: How to Improve Your EQ, Overcome and Coping with Negative Emotions like Anxiety and Fear, and Transform Your Relationships. Written by Hannah White. Narrated by Taylor Harvey. Introduction. The emotions that people carry with them throughout the day are diverse. People can go from feeling happy, to sad, to excited, to worried. Sometimes, a person could experience all of these feelings in just a few hours. These emotions are vital to everyone's life. The emotions that people have will dictate many of the things that they do. The things that people think and feel are always more powerful than the actions they do. It is vital for a person's emotional intelligence to be managed well. However, it is important for people who want to improve their EQ to understand what it entails and how it can be used. The first thing to do when working with emotional intelligence is to understand what it is. Emotional intelligence is a vital part of life that all people need to possess if they are to be successful and strong-willed individuals. Emotional intelligence refers to a person's ability to manage one's emotions and to handle the emotions of other people as well. It is about knowing what someone is feeling and having the ability to identify what makes those feel different. A universal sense of control is needed for making this part of one's life easy, without adding anything frustrating to the relationship. This concept is also known as the EQ, or emotional quotient. It is different from the traditional intelligence quotient that is utilized to measure a person's intelligence. Emotional intelligence has been a topic of interest to many businesses and organizations over the years. Although the concept of EQ was first introduced in the 1960s, it was not until the later part of the 20th century that people began to take note of EQ. This happened because mental health and a person's ability to perform on the job have become very important considerations. The five main categories. There are five categories of emotional intelligence. The 5 points were introduced by Daniel Goleman, a prominent behavioral sciences expert. Goleman released these 5 steps based on understanding what people can do to be stronger leaders in the workplace and to be more proficient in what they can do when helping others. The concepts continue to be important to this day. 1. Self-awareness. This refers to how well a person is aware of emotions in oneself and other people. This includes having a clear idea of what people might feel when handling emotions and seeing what causes them to develop. 2. Self-regulation. Self-regulation is the act of having control over one's emotions. This includes knowing how long an emotion will last and what can be done to keep an emotion from persisting. 3. Motivation. Motivation is how to use goals and efforts in one's life. This includes seeing what a person can do while using the right emotions to get where one wants to go. 4. Empathy. While emotional intelligence often focuses on knowing one's own emotions, empathy is knowing how others feel. This includes understanding what people are thinking and knowing how to react. 5. Social skills. The ability to interact with people in a positive fashion is vital to one's success. A person with a high EQ will have the social skills needed to get along with others. This includes understanding how to manage nonverbal communications. Chapter 1. EQ may be more important than IQ. A good intelligence quotient, or IQ, is helpful for life. Knowing and understanding how to make logical and rational decisions is advantageous to everyone. At the same time, that IQ can only take people so far. For instance, Jeffrey, a business executive, has a very high IQ. He is thought of with many useful ideas for his business, and yet he is unable to get his business to expand or grow. He is having a hard time maintaining his payroll because people are constantly leaving the business. Why is Jeffrey unable to get his business to grow? He is struggling with his EQ. He is not fully appreciative of his employees. Perhaps he does not understand that they need some balance between their work and their personal lives. This includes issues where workers are not satisfied with their jobs or are feeling too tired or uncomfortable with their work. But Jeffrey does not have the empathy to understand this. As a result, it becomes hard for even his smartest ideas to thrive and grow. If he had a better EQ, he would make more plans based on what other people need. By adapting his ideas and values around what others want, it would become easier for his business to grow and thrive. It is through one's EQ that it becomes easier to evolve and change. What makes it different from personality? What makes EQ different from a person's standard personality? EQ focuses more on feelings, while the personality is all about a person's style. There are three things that make up every person. 1. The intelligence quotient. 2. The emotional intelligence. 3. General personality. Personality is hardwired into one's brain. It is how a person would interact with others and behave in some fashion. Someone's personality can never change. The EQ is different, as a person can develop it over time. When a person is trained well, it becomes easier for that person to be active and positive. Many points about improving one's EQ will be covered throughout this guide to provide simple ideas for what they can do to get their lives to move forward. A person's IQ is likely to stay the same throughout one's life. A person has a certain ability to learn things at a specific rate. It might be easier for a person to learn emotions and how to manage them if that person's IQ is not low. EQ might be related to IQ when all is considered. When a person's EQ is high, it becomes easier for someone to want to learn. That person will use one's IQ to one's advantage. The emotions become balanced so that people fully understand what they can do to grow their lives. As a result, a person will use one's intelligence at a slightly better rate. The emotional intelligence that a person holds is important for all people who want to accomplish the most in their workplaces. Chapter 2. What makes EQ special? Emotional intelligence is more than just something relating to knowing what people feel. It is to understand and recognize what can be done to help others, or to at least get along with them. It is through a person's EQ that someone can get the most out of life. Anyone who has a high level of emotional intelligence will be more likely to succeed and thrive in one's work. There are several positives of one's EQ that must be explored. These points are vital for the workplace in particular, as they relate to what people can do to move forward and thrive in their jobs. Get along with people. A workplace is often a challenging place. Each person brings their personalities, their biases, and their different levels of intelligence and experience to the work environment. They have to work in harmony, and this is not always easy. There is also the added pressure of competition involved. Personal relationships outside of the workplace can be difficult at times as well. People often struggle with maintaining friendships. Finding a long-lasting romantic relationship can be challenging to some people. Those with a high EQ are better equipped to get along with others. A high EQ individual will understand the ups and downs of relationships and make smart plans to avoid conflicts and to settle disagreements effectively. Become more productive. People who have a high EQ are more likely to be productive. Those people understand what they want out of their lives and aren't afraid of putting in the effort. Let's say that there were two software engineers, Janet and Tom. They are working on the same task. Tom does not have much EQ and is not fully aware.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.